Hello friends, today I am going to explain storefront customer registration form or customer create account form. In this form we can see there are multiple default fields like a person inform, person first name, last name, sign up for newsletter, allow remote shipping assistant, that is new feature in the Magento 2.4 version, sign in from email, password, confirm, that's it. Sometimes when we were working, we need to require some additional field like a suffix, prefix, Mr., Mrs., juniors in the suffix, junior, senior, like a telephone number, like a date of birth, or like a company, or like the tax number, etc. So today we will learn how to increase this field or add additional this field in the this form. For this purpose, I am going to inside of admin, Magento 2 admin. I am already inside of admin. Need to go stores, need to go setting, need to click on the configuration. Once click on the configuration, we need to go is a customer and customer configuration option. Then right side panel will be open with a multiple tab, like account sharing, online customer option, up to the number of options. We need to click on name and address options. So those fields are given, these are represented in the customer registration form or customer create account form. And some of the form like address option is displaying on the like a billing and shipping address form. Let us start how can you add additional field in the customer account or customer registration form. And for this purpose, name we are going first, number of lines in street address, this is by default, yes. 3, this is for billing and shipping address form, we are not modifying this one or not updating anything here, that form, that's why I'm not doing anything here. Now go to the show prefix. I'm going to the prefix here. We need to click required. It will display Mr. and Mrs. before the first name in your registration customer registration form. Prefix drop down option, leave it, don't need to this one. Okay, then show middle name. If you want to show middle name, you can put the yes. So suffix name required, yes. Suffix drop down on, then do here some other names with the suffix name you want. Not here, not required because it's already on here. So date of birth, want to date of birth required, yes. So tax or VAT number, yes. If you want, you can put the VAT number. So gender number by default, no, we can put the yes required. So telephone number required, we can put the required. So company name, it's an option, you can put the option or required here and put click the option. So fax number, here I am putting the option of this field also. So you can see all these fields we need to add. We need to click and add. So on the drop down, it will display prefix, Mr. and Mrs., middle name, and suffix. So suffix will be junior, senior, and date of birth field, tax field, gender field, telephone field, company field, fax field will display after clicking on the save config button. Let's see, click on the save config button. Once it's done, need to clear cache, indexing and cache of the page. Let's see, click on save config button. Now going to the command prompt. Once it's saved, you can check it's save or not. Once it's save, it will display the message. Yeah, the configuration message coming. You can see message is coming. You save the configuration. Now going to the CLI command to run the index and plus command. Running the index command. Let's see, it is running very fast. then go to the plus command. Now going to the home page, we can open this page in incognito so that it will be run fast. It's running here. It's a taking time because we have cleared the cache. Let's see it. It's still running. Please be wait. It's returning. Now it has been done. Now you can see all fields as per your the admin configuration is displaying properly, like a name prefix, first name, middle name, last name, name suffix, date of birth field, text and VAT number, and also you can see what field you have selected as required. It displaying with the asterisk, like a tax, date of birth, name prefix, last name, name suffix, stick, gender required, yes, then email, then password. Okay, these all things are displayed. Now we can keep the registration and check how these things are running. Let's see. Mr. John, John D, we are not putting last name, is not compulsory, middle name is not compulsory, we are not putting John D, senior, we can put the senior here, date of birth, you can put the date of birth, 1990. The print text, we can put the bet 1010 is a dummy bet number, gender, then we can put the email address John and put the password. Now we can click here. It's running. Please be wait. Time, please be wait. Now it has been done. So you can see account has been created. Once go to the account information, you can see all your additional fields along with the all existing fields are displaying proper. Name, first name, middle name, we didn't put, last name, suffix, senior, date of birth, port, April 99. Text number, gender, all things are displaying properly. So we can see also in the database how they are storing. Let's see. Going inside on the database. So inside the database, we are going to the database. We need to click customer underscore entity table. Okay, go there and select all from customer underscore entity. Table, we can click here to display the value. So it's a displaying all values like John D, group ID, created. You can see all fields, first name, prefix, last name, suffix, date of birth, password option, and gender. It's a male for the one that is value one, which is one. So in this way, it is being all things in the your admin end properly on database end properly. So it's a money. So in this way, we can increase decrease number of fields on the registration for as per your need. So if you anytime you need to go your account and you can modify the your all field including a name to the other fields. Now I'm going to log out and again log in. Let's see what happens. Still log out. Now it's a log on. Now I'm going to log in. Can see John D USA 1021 read. It's running for the login. So again, we can go to the your account information and you can see. Yes, it's all bits are displayed. So guys, in this way you can increase the number of fields or additional field in the customer registration form or customer create account form on the store prints. Thanks for watching this video. Very soon I will be available with next upcoming video. Please be share, subscribe, like this video. Thank you.